Welcome to another edition of Hours and Minutes, where we take hours of information and condense it into just a few palatable minutes. With me today, we have Mickey Vogt. He is BUI's leader of the case design team, a product guru, and a new mother to Tommy, the cutest little boy you've ever seen. So today we are talking about long-term care insurance and specifically Plan B options. So Mickey, many clients are surprised about the rigidity of long-term care insurance underwriting, especially those that are accustomed to life insurance underwriting, which has a lot of flexibility, a lot of rate classes. With long-term care insurance, you're kind of in or you're out. So for somebody who is not accepted for long-term care insurance underwriting, what options might exist from a product perspective?
There's actually a couple of different products that can be available for these clients. The first is adding a chronic illness rider to a permanent life insurance plan. There's also certain riders that can be added to a traditional long-term care plan for those clients who are married and can add those on to their spouse's plan.
Got it. So you said chronic illness rider. So I think a lot of people who work with BUI at least are familiar with hybrid plans, which are life insurance policies with a long-term care insurance rider. Very popular in the market. Is a chronic illness rider and a long-term care rider the same thing?
You know, they're very similar, but there's a few very important differences to note when you're looking at these plans. The first is that some of these riders require a permanency requirement in order to go on claim. Not all of them do anymore, but it is something to pay attention to. What that means is that if, say, for example, I had a broken hip with a long-term care insurance rider, I could go on claim and then off claim again. With some chronic illness riders, you have to be careful because your doctor would have to say you're never going to get better again in order to go on claim. A couple of other things to note with these plans is that there is a HIPAA per diem max limit that you can get for coverage, as well as there's sometimes some hidden fees and things that can be put into these products. So, for example, you might have to pay a fee just to go on claim. Because of that, there can be a little bit less leverage for your dollar towards the long-term care that you might need versus a long-term care plan.
So permanency, less transparency, fees, things like that. So you also mentioned on traditional plans that there are certain riders that may be helpful in this situation. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. With some traditional long-term care plans, they offer what's called a security benefit. It's a rider that can be added to a person's plan to cover their spouse. So what we see a lot of times is that this rider will provide a percentage of the coverage. So it's probably not going to be an apples to apples 100% of matching plan, but maybe 60%. So the spouse might have a plan and they're going to have their reimbursement coverage and their pool of money. But on top of that, an indemnity check is written out to their spouse for that 60%. That will cover them should the insured go on claim. The nice thing about these types of riders is that a lot of times when two people apply for insurance together and one is declined, there's an emotional reaction and both walk away from the table without coverage. That way they're not protecting their family at all. This allows for them to, even if it's not the full amount of coverage they had planned on purchasing before, give some benefit to both clients.
So in that example, the spouse would not have to provide evidence of insurability?
Correct. They don't have to be uninsurable to get this rider, but they wouldn't have to provide any evidence of insurability. It's just added on as long as the spouse with the policy is insured.
Got it. So not to put you on the spot, but would you be able to provide sort of an example of like a case study that might be applicable to that rider?
Sure. So for example, say my husband and I were trying to purchase long-term care insurance and he was uninsurable. I could then purchase my plan, say I wanted a $5,000 monthly benefit and add the security benefit rider. Then when I went on claim, I would get my full reimbursement benefits for $5,000 with an additional $3,000 because it's 60% of indemnity benefits for my husband. Because it's indemnity, it doesn't have to be used just for coverage for him. It can be used for whatever he needs it for. It could be additional coverage for me. It could be to build ramps in our house, whatever we need at that point in time. A lot of times this is really nice for clients, say the insured is the one taking care of their spouse and then they need coverage themselves. When they go on claim, now they both have a little bit of something to cover them.
Nice. helpful information, and I couldn't help but notice that you made your husband uninsurable, not you. Good stuff.
Well, of course.
All right, Mickey. Well, very helpful information. Thank you for joining me today. For anybody that has questions related to chronic illness riders or security benefit riders, Mickey's available at BY's main number, and anybody in the case design team can also assist. Anybody that has questions for future hours and minutes, please email them to marketing@buiusa.com.